because that touches us very closely, and that relates to the beloved son of our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Imam Hassan and Hussein are regarded as sons of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sahaba Ikram used to call them Ya Ibn Rasul. The other incidents relate to previous prophets alayhi salam and previous ummats. This incident relates to our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the family of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and a great sacrifice of this ummat. Therefore, as I said, it closely touches us and it brings back the memories of the shahadat, the sacrifices, the bravery, the courage of Ahl-e Bayt, the members of the house of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and their determination to stand up to protect the deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is the main reason that we are closely linked with the incident of Karbala. We do talk about other incidents as well, but what greatly touches us is the incident of Karbala. Sacrifice your children.
Subhanallah.
Sacrifice your money.
Subhanallah.
Sacrifice your time. Sacrifice your health, your wealth, your own life to uplift the deen. Sacrificing your children. Send them to become hafiz, qari, alim. And there are many other ways of spending them in the path of Allah. Your children are risk as well, and from every risk you should give zakat. You want all your sons to become doctors, engineers, you know, scientists, lawyers, accountants, because you know that they earn a lot of money. So where is the sacrifice? So You and this is something that you can practice in every age, in every century, and at any time. You can't say that 1400 years ago you could sacrifice and today you can't. So the main lesson of the incident of Karbala is sacrifice for thee. Well, those who say these kind of things, they are on the side of Yazid. And Alhamdulillah, we are on the side of Imam Hussein.
Subhanallah.
So we are Husseinis.
Subhanallah.
Sunnis are Husseinis.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah.
To be Husseini is the haqq of every Sunni.
Beshak.
Because we are the balanced people. We love them. We love Ahle Bayt. We love Sahaba Ikram. Those who lose the balance, they love no one. So, Alhamdulillah, we are on the side of Imam Hussein, and those who say it was a political thing and he wanted some share in the government or power, they are on the side of Yazid. So it's now up to you with the, whose group you want to be. You want to be with the group of Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, you want to be with the group of Yazid, Palid, filthy. So it's your choice. Love is not about lip service. You know, a lot of people use this word a lot. Husband, wives, but the other spouse says, I don't trust you. So because they know, the person says something else and does something else. So when you say something else and do something else, then that's a lip service. So a true lover of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will follow the shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The true lover of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu would not show rebellion towards the shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because what Hazrat Imam Hussain did, he fought with a person who went against the shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not allow a rebellious sinner to lead the Muslims. Shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam demands that an upright person must lead the Muslims. So he followed the shariat of his grandfather. So when you talk about Husainiyat, it's all about strengthening the deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And how would you strengthen if your own exercise is against what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has established? So lip service is not accepted. Allah knows what is in the hearts. From your actions, something must be shown that you are genuine, you are true.
SubhanAllah.
Building a model of any building or tree or scenery is jais. Things that are lifeless. Like you make a mold of Roza Mubarak of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or you make a model of Khana Kaaba, and you keep in your office or you keep in your house, absolutely fine, nothing wrong with it. So if somebody, you know, loves Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and his love demands him that I want to keep his Roza Mubarak in front of my eyes, 100% right, no problem with that. But if you have a model of Kaaba, you don't go and make tawaf around it and do Hajj and Umrah. So, if person has made the model of the mazar of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, so that is his love and for him to link up. So if they do anything other than that, then that would be prohibited and they must be stopped. So people know who go, I don't go. So I don't know what happens there, but people tell us a lot of stories. And if those stories are true, then people must watch their steps, they must watch their practices and do things which are sanctioned by Sharia. Everyone has to follow Sharia, nobody is exempted. So that's something that we need to learn. This is actually a history. Some of the enemies of Hazrat Sayyidina Ali al-Murtaza Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to curse Hazrat Ali al-Murtaza Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they used to say bad words regarding his face Mubarak. So the scholars started using this word Karramallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem, that Ali is that person whose face Allah has honored. So this was a reply and answer to those people who were insulting the face Mubarak of Hazrat Ali al-Murtaza Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But the person answered himself, I don't need to answer, he said, there's a lot of haram activities take place. So he answered the question. So when these activities are haram, not sanctioned by Sharia, so what is your answer? That's my answer. No, it's not bidat, it's ordered. Because it's mentioned in Hadith Mubarakah, you must make wus'at of rizq upon your family. Mean, feed them lot of nice things, lot of foods. So now, if you cook vegetable only, you have not fed them lot of things. If you feed them meat only, you have not fed them a lot of things. So the early Muslims, the wise Muslim, they said, no, let's make a dish that have many ni'mats in it. Meat is there, chana dal is there, moong dal is there, masoor dal is there, chawal is there, the bali is there, the vegetables are there, onions are there, spices are there. So many things they put together and they make a dish. So you are feeding your family lot of ne'mats.
Subhanallah.
So they call it khichda. We say khichda. This is how we should say, because Haleem is the, you know, attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should change that word. We should call it khichda. Can I tell you a Haleem story? I heard this from a good scholar. He said, you know, early days when people from subcontinent Indo-Pak used to go for Hajj or Umrah, they used to see Arabs making dish. And till now they have a, you know, like a deeg lying there, and then they have, you know, a dish mixed with meat and, you know, all these kind of dals and etc. And they used to enjoy. So, its name was Laheem. You know, with Lahmun. So, yeah. When something is very meaty, in Arabic it's called Laheem. Not Laheem. Even when a person is very fat, you know, people who speak Arabic, sometimes they call him, he's very laheem, because he carries a lot of meat on his body.
Subhanallah.
Okay, so Arabs were calling laheem, and our people got the recipe and they forgot the name. So instead of calling it laheem, they started calling it haleem. So this is where the technical mistake happened. Now, because it has gone so famous everywhere, people call it Haleem. So then the careful ulama, they suggested, let's start calling, you know, this dish something else. They call it khichda. Khichda is like a lot of things mixed up. So we should call it khichda. Yeah, no, definitely the lahm issue, the meat issue is related to this dish. Otherwise, in the right sense, Muslims know from the beginning that, you know, Haleem is the attribute of Allah. They will not keep the name of a food or dish that they eat. So they made some mistake, they got mixed up, and they started calling Haleem, and then it became famous, you know, Ghalatul Awam.
Subhanallah.
Both are shaheed, both have contributed a lot, but you must know that person who suffers more in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, he will be remembered more and appreciated more. The more suffering you face, the more difficulties you face, the more pain you take. So in the martyrdom of Hazrat Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala, it was so secret that no one even knows who's the killer. You know, the person who gave poison, no one knows. People just have some guesses. And Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala and his martyrdom is so clear, is so open, that even the injuries on his body are counted. How many injuries of spears, how many injuries of arrows, how many injuries of swords. And the purpose, why it happened. And then so many of his children, his nephews, his family members, his friends are being slaughtered in the Maidan-e-Karbala. He's carrying their bodies, bringing them into the tents and then going and then fighting. It's a very painful. It's very hard, very, very hard. And that's what makes him Sayyid al-Shuhada. There are a lot of Shaheeds, but he's regarded as the leader of Shuhada, the king of Shuhada. Martyrdom is something to be celebrated.
Subhanallah.
Martyrdom is not something that you should mourn at. So, to refresh grief is not allowed. When did this incident happen? Yesterday? How many centuries ago? You must remember them, remember their contribution, remember their sacrifices, remember their revolution, and inspire the Ummah so we can have more people who are ready to give their everything for the sake of Islam. There's no time for mourning. Refreshing grief, making grief fresh all over again, that's not part of the deen of Islam. For that reason, Allah Hazrat radiallahu ta'ala and many other great scholars have said, women are not allowed to go to the Qabristan. What reason do they give? Because they are emotional people and they refresh grief. So for that reason, then grief is allowed for 3 days. And the woman who lost her husband, she is allowed 4 months and 10 days according to lunar calendar. So you can't continue with this. So remember Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his martyrdom with the reference of his bravery.
Subhanallah.
With the reference of his shuja'at.
Subhanallah.
With the reference of his trust in Allah.
Subhanallah.
With the reference of his determination and his caring about deen and his caring about practicing the shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are the aspects that should be highlighted more than making it like a sad story. So-and-so Imam Sahib or so-and-so Maulana, is he a lawmaker? Lawmaker is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanallah.
Maulana must follow law. Peer sahab must follow law. Mufti sahab must follow law.
Subhanallah.
You know, sometimes some people, they see something. Not everybody has the courage to tell on that time. Or maybe the atmosphere is not right. Sometimes person just makes sabr and, you know, he forces himself to sit for a while and then he goes away. But in his heart, he doesn't like it. That's not a proof for someone that, oh, so-and-so saw it and he didn't stop it. So it's right. Right and wrong is proven from the Sharia, not from the action of some Maulana or some Peer Sahab. That must be remembered. Model is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ مُسْوَةٌ
حَسَنٌ.
The best model is in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everyone else must follow.
Jannati. Jannati.
Hasanain Kareeman bhi.
Jannati.
Subhanallah.
See, when we say Har Sahabi Nabi, Jannati. Some people think that we are excluding Ahle Bayt. So Ahle Bayt are also Sahabi. Hazrat Ali is Sahabi, Hazrat Imam Hassan is Sahabi, Hazrat Imam Hussain is Sahabi. Hazrat Bibi Fatima to Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha, she is Sahabiya. All Azwaj-e Mutahharat, they are Sahabiyat.
Subhanallah.
So what Sahabi covers all of them. Har Sahabiye Nabi.
Jannati.
And this is the wada.
Subhanallah.
Wa kullam wa'adallahu al-husna.
Subhanallah.
All those Sahaba who became Muslims before Fatha Makkah. And all those who became Muslims after Fatha Makkah. وَكُلَّمْ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised them Jannat.
بِشَكْ.
So they are categorically Jannati. And let me tell you that Jahannami and Jannati cannot see eye to eye.
بِشَكْ.
A Jahannami is always enemy of Jannati. So if someone bad mouths any Sahabi, there will be no harm to Sahabi, but he is announcing, come see me, I'm the dog of Jahannam. He's announcing and he's telling people, so now I can't stop him. I mean, if he has decided to, you know, humiliate himself, then let him do. He has his choice. I can't stop him. The ulama ikram have said, Allah has said that those who badmouth Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala, no, they are kilabul haviya. And we wrote a fatwa recently, which we would issue soon. Ambaul Haviya li Adai Abi Sufyan wa Muawiyah. News of hell for the enemies of Hazrat Sufyan and Hazrat Amir Muawiyah.
Allah.
Mm-hmm. Don't associate with them. Don't sit with them. Don't listen to them.
I heard.
You will be saved. See, the problem is, before it was much safer, now it's very dangerous. Before, when we said, don't go to listen to bad mazhabs or this one or that one, people came to the masjid of Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah and listened to particular Sunni scholars. And now through the social media, every Tom, Dick and Harry is coming into your house. Clips are, listen to these clips, family, friends. Even you know, my family group, sometimes I see a wrong clip is there and then I have to tell them. Okay, I know these things, I tell them. But a lot of other people don't know these things. So, when you are exposed to every kind of discussions and talks and you believe, no, I can handle, I know who am I, what is my aqidah, you don't know, that's the nafs and shaitan is misguiding you. One thing can get stuck in your head and you can change your whole aqidah. So the best way to protect yourself is, don't listen to the clip of any person who is bad mazhab, don't listen to his lecture face to face or online or on the net. Otherwise you in danger, in very big danger. An ordinary person, how much do you know about deen? How much do you know about aqaid? Something person can say and can click to you and you're gone. Because your mind can't give that answer. So many people were gone. You know when people came and said, Allah can speak lie. So the people said, how can he do that? And they said, well, tell us, is man more powerful or Allah more powerful? So everyone said, Allah is more powerful. So are you saying that man can do something and Allah can't do something? What are you saying? Yeah, man can speak lie, why can't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak lie? It clicked to a lot of people. A man comes after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he says, I'm a Nabi. It clicked to a lot of people and they got their own organizations and they have become, you know, quite powerful in their own circles. Any nonsense can click to people if they give hearing to it. So you are only saved if you don't give hearing to any person who's bad mazhab.
Subhanallah. Bishop, Bishop. Bishop.
Definitely, definitely.
SubhanAllah.
Pages to be followed. There's so many pages to be followed, but we are still actually we also want the fun, isn't it? That's what he says. Let's see what he says. Let's not do that. Because
curious. They're curious.
Inshallah.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
That's the share for the Ashkane Rasul.
Subhanallah.
If you really want to rock, then you rock on this share when you understand it.
Subhanallah.
This refers to Hadith Mubarakah in which it is said that on the day of judgment, when you know people are standing, the day of Qiyamah being the day of standing. You know, for so long standing, sun is so near, perspiring, so difficult. They want to get out of this situation. So they go to Ambiga. First of all, they will think of what to do. And they will reach a conclusion, let's go to the beloveds of Allah. With their wasila, we'll get something. So those who deny the wasila, will take wasila.
Kahenge aare nabi zahab ila ghairi mere nabi ke labon pe ana laha
He started reading the shir. I hope people heard it. And so they will go to Prophet salam, and all prophets will say to them, "Nafsi, nafsi,
Allah,
idhabu ila ghairi.
Allah,
I'm worried about my own self. Go to somebody else." And then finally, when they will reach to Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, he'll tell them, "I'll give you the proper address. That's where you must go." He gave us news, good news before. Min ba'd ismuhu Ahmad. Ya'ti min ba'd ismuhu Ahmad.
Subhanallah.
The one who's coming after me, his name is Ahmad. He gave us that news. Good news. And he will give that good news on the day of judgment.
Subhanallah.
He will take the name and he will say, "Go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam." Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And when people will go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will see them. He'll ask them, "Where have you been?" They will say, "We were looking for shafa'at." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, "Ana laha."
Subhanallah.
"I am for that."
Subhanallah.
So this is that share that is, look, this is a topic on its own, this is a speech on its own. But remember, in South Africa we have curfew time, and we almost reaching curfew time, because from here we need to pack up and before 10 o'clock we must be at home. So we law abiding citizens don't want to violate any rule. So I think we can conclude the program here.
Inshallah.
We can make a short dua. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim salatan wa salaman alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب الحشر واحشرنا مع الأبرار
آمين
يا إله العالمين حضرت امام حسين سيد الشهداء امام علي مقام رضي الله تعالى عنه كصدقاء تمام شهداء كربلاء كصدقاء
آمين
مغفرت فرما
آمين
يا الله جو پیغام حضرت امام حسين رضي الله تعالى عنه نے اس امت کے لیے چھوڑا ہے یا اللہ اس پہ ہمیں عمل کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرما شہداء کربلا کا صدقہ یا اللہ کرونا وائرس کو اس دنیا سے بھگا دے
آمین
جو بیمار ہیں انہیں شفا دے جو مسلمان فوت ہو گئے انہیں شہادت کا مرتبہ عطا فرما
آمین
یا اللہ سارے عالم اسلام پر اپنا کرم فرما اپنا فضل فرما ببرکات ان اللہ و ملائکتہ یصلون علی النبی يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa barik wa sallim salatan wa salamun alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah salatan wa salamun alayka ya Sayyidi ya Habiballah سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.